Today we're talking about the 13th study in the book of 32 studies by Rose. This is a favorite on many Allstate auditions, and it's a terrific etude to cover because I get to share a couple of little-known clarinet tricks with you. So here's what we're going to cover, just so you can get excited. Generally, though, we'll be talking about how to play softly, expressively, and actually beautifully. The most unbeautiful type of slow clarinet playing I call playing football dynamics. So we'll hit that first, but playing soft high notes in particular is a real challenge. So I'll give you one tip and one trick to get up into the high clarion and altissimo without clenching your butt cheeks and biting your reed. Next, we'll talk about how to tongue very lightly. I've got a great trick I've used forever. You'll like it too. It's so simple. First off, let's talk about the Italian and French words on the page. I know Google Translate can be your friend, because it certainly was mine when I looked at the first term on the page here, piangevolmente. I've literally never seen that word before in my life, so I looked it up. David Hite, though, must have had to pull out his Italian dictionary, since it's not in the original version of this study. So I'll save you the trouble of going to YouTube. It means plaintive, or in the style of a lament. Now, I know many of you already lament slow studies like this, so it should be pretty easy for you to get into the vibe. Next, if you're not playing this with a metronome, I would be willing to bet that you are not playing it in rhythm. Slow music with the kinds of subdivided notes you see in this etude make it really, really, really easy to stop playing in rhythm. So next to the musicality, this rhythm, clean, accurate rhythm is what is being judged here if you're playing this in Allstate. If you don't play it in rhythm, someone else surely will. So get out your metronome or metronome app and follow it. Okay, so let's talk about footballs. What do footballs have to do with music, and what do I mean by dynamic footballs? Well, let me demonstrate, because I have heard probably a million players, especially young players, playing like this when they're trying to play musically. I call it a football when you play each individual note with a swell and a decrescendo, such that the notes sound like a football looks, tapered at the end and big in the middle. You want to know what else is tapered at the end and big in the middle? Don't do it, because it isn't musical. You may think it's musical because you are playing with dynamics. So here's what you really need to do. Play the dynamics that David Hite, the editor of this book, wrote in. They're pretty extensive. You'll also notice that they indicate larger phrases. Individual notes are not phrases, you know, I guess unless you get into something like Messiaen Quartet for the End of Time, but that's maybe a little bit more advanced than Rose. Okay, so let's look at these first phrases. The first phrase is 3.5 measures long. The next phrase is 4.5 measures long. And there are dynamics inside each of these phrases, sure, but the whole phrase is a breath. Conveniently, David Hite also marks in breaths to A, help you breathe, and B, help you identify phrases and subphrases within the phrases. All right, so it starts piano, and it stays piano for the first 2.5 measures. Play this super smoothly. And playing this smoothly requires that you've warmed up with your long tones. You did warm up with long tones, didn't you? And you use constant and consistent air support. Blow through the instrument. Blow more than you think that you have to for a soft sound. It actually takes basically the same amount of air support to play softly as it does loud. So keep those abs engaged. That way, you can make a nice crescendo and diminuendo in measures 3 and 4, and by blowing, you will not tense up. If you blow air through the instrument, it will relax you, and that just makes everything work better for you. Next, let's talk about the 32nd notes throughout this first half. Just because it looks hard and fast doesn't mean that it's hard and fast. Play these notes like a turn. See last week's video if you want a discussion of turns. And above all, do not play aggressively, especially when it's loud. Yes, there's a temptation here for you to show off your finger technique, but save that for another piece. Here, it's all about doing something technical that doesn't sound technical. I'll demonstrate the difference here in measures 17 through 20. I'll first play it sort of aggressively, then I'll play it the way I'm talking about, with fast but delicate finger and air movement. Thank you. So what you should do is just play it without the 32nd notes, just once, so that you can see what the main line here is. So it should be just that smooth, except with those other notes in it. Okay, now we're up to my first playing softly tip. Measure 27 here asks you to start on a high A, one of the harder notes to speak when playing softly, and on top of that you have to trill. So here's the trick. You press the clarinet gently but firmly into your top teeth, like so. I'm pushing pretty hard, and I notice it here. It's better if you have a teeth cushion, because otherwise if you're just playing right on the mouthpiece without a teeth cushion, it feels pretty weird and your teeth slide all over the place. So having a teeth cushion is really helpful. It doesn't have to be thick, it just needs to be there so that your teeth have something to grip onto. Anyway, pushing the clarinet using your right hand and your thumb, possibly your knees if you put your clarinet between your knees. If you're standing up, you have to use your thumb, but you want to push it into your top teeth pretty hard so that you notice it. What that does is keep you from biting with your lower lip and squeezing that note so that it sounds thin and strained. Here, I'll show you. I guarantee you won't bite nearly as much, if at all. Next, since we're talking about playing softly while playing high, let's jump ahead to the last note in this etude. Here is a great fingering for playing that high D. It's part of a series of fingerings that pros use to play softly up there in pieces like Respighi's Pines of Rome, and it's called the Backless D. It's backless because you play it without closing this FC hole here in the back with your left thumb. Here's the fingering to look at. Notice the register key is used without the thumb F. It may take a little while to get used to, but those high Ds come out so much easier. Give it a try, you'll love it, I promise. If you don't, I'll give you your money back. Here, I'll demonstrate it for you. Here's the regular D. A little sharper. That's actually more in tune, and it's so much easier to play. So. So it's a smoother interval. You've got more fingers down, so there's less of a break in the airstream. It's just so much easier. All right, you're welcome. Moving along here, let's go back to measure 36. Now, in the TMEA, that's Texas Music Educators Association, Allstate instructions, there is a comment that they would like you to articulate the triplets in that measure. Just that measure, but fine. Now, what they mean is articulate underneath the slur. But how do you articulate under a slur? Isn't that a contradiction? No, it's actually something that you'll see from time to time. And what that means is really it's just a slur with a light tongue to separate the notes. This seems like it's hard to do, but here's this last trick. Tongue half the reed. You pick a side of the reed, the left side or the right side. So you're just tonguing that side of the reed softly. The other side of the reed continues to vibrate, and you get the best of both worlds. One side of the reed is slurring, the other side is being tongued, and that's how you do it. I'll demonstrate. What I'm going to do is I'm going to choose the left side in this particular case, and I'm going to play the note, and I'm going to put my tongue on the left side of the reed while continuing to blow. At the same time, I'm going to rotate the clarinet over to the left toward the side that I'm tonguing, and you will hear that the note is just softer, but it still vibrates. If I were to play it normally, so I'm going to rotate, I'm going to blow, and then I'm going to tongue now. It's really, really delicate, and it has the effect, really, of both slurring and tonguing at the same time, which is what's written here. All right, so we're at the end here. That is the 13th of the Rose 32 study. So please go practice with a metronome and come back next week when we will tackle another Allstate etude. If there is an Allstate etude that you would like to hear, please do not leave it in the comments. Please email me off the website, earspasm.com/contact, and I will take that under advisement. I can't do everything. There are a lot of states, but I'll do my best. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. Bye.